So it seems like not very long ago, the GDC released their 2016 State of the Gaming Industry paper online for people to read. And there's quite a lot of interesting information in this. However, I'm going to break it down to something very important, which is market share among developers. Now, the first things to note are what developers are making games for. 52% of developers said that they are making a PC game, and 44% said that they are making a game for smartphones and tablets. Now, this is something that's not very surprising considering the low entry barrier for both of those platforms, with the PC being even lower than mobile, considering how you can put just about anything on Steam Greenlight. The numbers for console developers are fairly strong too, with 28% of developers saying that they were making a game for the PS4 and 23% saying that they were making a game for the Xbox One. However, with Nintendo platforms, they are still dead in the water. 5% of them said that they were working on a game for the Wii U, and only 3% said that the game they were working on would be on the 3DS. And it's only going to get worse for Nintendo-only gamers, as 4% of developers believe that their next game will be on the Wii U, and 2% of them believe their next game will be on the 3DS. And this is compared to 29% on the PS4 and 23% on the Xbox One. Now sure, handhelds are dying and the writing's on the wall, but it's still pretty interesting to see that the Vita is doing better than the 3DS, with 4% of developers saying that they are making a game for it right now. And keep in mind for context, the numbers for the last gen consoles, 360 and PS3, are 5% and 4% respectively, and those are systems that are already on their way out, and they're doing just as well as the Wii U and Vita, and that's kind of sad, really, and it just shows you how dead those systems are. Another question asked what system developers were interested in working on. 31% were interested in the Xbox One, 42% were interested in the PS4, and just 8% were interested in the Wii U. And the NX was pretty vague because Nintendo hasn't given out much info on it, and only 10% of developers expressed an interest in the Nintendo NX. And now let's talk about some less relevant platforms. Remember those Android microconsoles that were being hyped up a few years ago? Well, as they sit and collect dust in stores, only 4% of developers are making a game for microconsoles, and only 4% of developers are interested in them as well, while only 10% are interested in making games for the Apple TV. And remember Steam machines, those systems that were supposed to kill off consoles? Well, only 21% of developers are interested in them. While that's more than the Wii U and micro consoles, that's still not a lot. And from what I could see on the poll, Linux support wasn't that great either, even though there was no percentage. So if you wasted money on a Steam machine, good luck getting games for it. And now my personal thoughts on this, well, to be fair, this confirms a lot of what I've been saying. I mean, how many gamers on this website do you see buying microconsoles or buying Steam machines? Because nobody seems to be buying those on this website, and nobody I know in real life owns a Steam machine or a microconsole whatsoever. And handhelds. Let's just say a few years ago, back when the Vita was newer and same with the 3DS, I had both of them, and whenever I'd play them, people would look at me like, hey, what's this new cool device you have? They knew nothing about what the Vita was, they probably haven't even seen an ad for either system, and they didn't have the big games that people were talking about, that even their little kid would be talking about. I mean, the Vita doesn't have Call of Duty, it doesn't have Madden, it doesn't have FIFA, it doesn't have all those games you see kids playing. I mean, it has Minecraft, and it has Terraria, but they're more likely playing them on their iPhone or Android phone anyways. They're not playing them on an expensive handheld. And while Nintendo used to be known for being the number one system for little kids, they've lost their position very rapidly to smartphones, as you're seeing more and more kids playing smartphones and fewer playing 3DSs and DSs. And in fact, just look at how the 3DS has sold a lot worse than the DS did during the same time frame, because the thing is, gamers and kids don't care about the 3DS like they did the DS. And that's the thing with handhelds. They are barely more relevant than Steam machines and microconsoles, and that's only because they have more shelf space at stores like GameStop, and you see more people online talking about them. And when you look at handhelds, you realize that the casuals are going over to smartphones. And when you see that game developers are treating the remaining handheld gamers like they're complete casuals, is it any wonder that handheld gaming is becoming irrelevant? I mean, unless you're looking for a new waifu simulator, you might as well go game on a PC or console instead. And of course, the Wii U is dead too, but is that any surprise? Because that's what happens to a company which puts out gimmicks instead of being sure that the system has games. And the Wii U's weak, underpowered, relies too much on gimmicks, and even many of the games aren't that great. I mean, who wanted that Animal Crossing Amiibo Festival game? Let's be honest here, who actually did? And if you've taken a look at recent high-profile console flops, such as the Ouya, or PlayStation Vita, or Wii U, one thing they've all had in common is they lack games, and especially mainstream games. Sure, the Wii U and PlayStation Vita have some niche games, but here's the thing. Game consoles don't sell based off niche games alone. They need to have games that the mainstream can buy. Sure, you'll see people talking a lot about the PlayStation 2's role-playing game library. It had games like Shin Megami Tensei Nocturne, but which game do you think PS2 gamers bought more? Shin Megami Tensei Nocturne or Grand Theft Auto San Andreas? They clearly went for San Andreas instead. And it's a pretty hard sell to most gamers to convince them to buy a several hundred dollar console for only a few games. If you have disposable income, that's one thing. But if you don't have disposable income and you have to only get one system, buying a system which only has a handful of games like the Wii U is a stupid investment. Now, I'm going to drop a link in the description to both the news article about this and the report itself, but you can take a look over it. It's an interesting read, and it shows you what systems developers are making games for. And it's not handhelds or Nintendo platforms either.